In today's video, I am going to explain muscles around pelvis and hip, and I will explain how you can apply today's anatomy for yoga, Pilates, and athletic performance. Today's key structure is bony structure. This is it. This bony ridge of pelvis is called iliac crest. This part is very important for pelvis and hip. Plus, this part is very important for core, pelvis, and hip. There are a lot of muscles attaching around iliac crest. And if you look carefully, there's inferior part and superior part on iliac crest, right? Then, if you go inferior from iliac crest, there are hip muscles. If you go superior from iliac crest, there are core muscles. So if you focus on iliac crest plus either inferior part of iliac crest or superior part of iliac crest, you can affect both for hip muscles and core muscles. Thus, iliac crest is freaking important landmark. Now let me explain hip muscles first. Again, on inferior part of iliac crest, there are hip muscles. First muscle is this one. This is big glute muscle. This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus, indeed, that attaches to iliac crest. Next one is this one. If there's gluteus maximus, there should be other gluteus muscle, right? This one is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius, that's on lateral part of pelvis and hip. But wait a minute, where is gluteus minimus? Gluteus minimus is deep to gluteus medius. It's like this. This is also important muscle. However, today's topic is about iliac crest. Gluteus minimus is far away from iliac crest. Thus, I will not talk about gluteus minimus today. Anyhow, gluteus maximus and gluteus medius attaches to inferior part of iliac crest. One more muscle, that is here, this one. You don't see exactly. This one is tensor fasciae latae. Tensor fasciae latae, it's on anterior part of iliac crest. See, if there's tension around iliac crest, particularly on inferior part, this tightness can affect for gluteus maximus, gluteus medius, and tensor fasciae latae. Vice versa, if these muscles get tight, that can create tightness or adhesion around iliac crest. Do you see this relationship? I will explain how you can apply today's anatomy later. Now let's go to superior part of iliac crest. What kind of muscles are there? Okay, on superior part, there are core muscles. First one is this one. This one is not actually core muscle, however, that's important one. This is latissimus dorsi. This muscle is actually shoulder muscle, but it originates from pelvis and sacrum. That's very rare muscle. It's on superior part of iliac crest. Next one is core muscle, abdominal muscle. This one. This is external oblique. External oblique. This is outermost abdominal muscle. See, it attaches to here, superior part of iliac crest. Next one, deep to external oblique, there is internal oblique. So that it attaches to here. Then let's go to deeper layer. Okay, latissimus dorsi is gone. See this muscle? This is part of erector spinae. It attaches to iliac crest. This one is erector spinae. Particularly about iliocostalis. Iliocostal part. It's on the most lateral part of erector spinae. Okay. Then you see part of abdominal muscle here. See, it attaches to superior part of iliac crest. This is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis, this is the deepest layer among abdominal muscles. One more muscle, but you don't see that. There is muscle like this. This muscle connects iliac crest and 12th rib. This pink one is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum, it of course attaches to iliac crest. See, there are numerous muscles attaching around iliac crest. If one of these muscles get tight, that may create adhesion around iliac crest. Of course, if gluteal muscles get tight, that may create adhesion here. Tight muscles, tight myofascia inhibits movement of pelvis. Now, how can you apply today's anatomy for yoga, Pilates, stretching, athletic performance? Let me explain that. Okay, this is side body stretching. This person's lateral part of body is stretched out, right? Now, her iliac crest is about here. This is iliac crest. Remember, on superior part, abdominal muscles attaching to iliac crest, right? Imagine like this. There is external oblique, internal oblique, transverse abdominis. And if you go to posterior part, there is erector spinae, latissimus dorsi. So if you focus on iliac crest and you do this kind of side body stretching, maybe tissues around iliac crest get more stretched, get more effect, because visualization of muscles and intention that you're working on particular muscle, that gives better efficiency for stretching. Having visualization is freaking important. Again, this part is iliac crest. There are many muscles around iliac crest. You do side body stretching, you have effect for these kind of muscles. But how about inferior part? How about hip muscles? To be honest, this person's lower extremity is not stretched out. Thus, in this sitting position, you can't affect for hip muscles a lot, because it's just lower extremity is not stretched out. Alright, now, how can you affect for inferior part? This is one example. This is one of yoga pose. This is triangle pose. Again, her iliac crest is about here. Again, above iliac crest, there are abdominal muscles, latissimus dorsi, erector spinae. Of course, in this triangle pose, you can affect for superior part. Of course, that affects for inferior part. Look at that. Gluteus medius, gluteus maximus, tensor fascia are about here. Now, you can affect for inferior part. See, this person is very flexible. You see good length through upper body and lower body. Now you have a visualization of where iliac crest is and what kind of muscles are around iliac crest. You have visualization, you have vision in your head. Now you can focus what kind of muscles there are. Then your yoga practice, Pilates practice, athletic practice can be better. This is very important thing. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.